Welcome to Quinnipiac University, Bobcats Unleashed. I'm Jamie Parker. Today we'll visit with the Quinnipiac University hockey team as one of the premier Division I teams in the region on the keys of recruiting for success. We'll also talk with some student athletes and the challenges they face with their commitment to the team and the classroom, never mind a social life. And we'll find out how specific injuries are targeting certain student athletes and what is being done to help prevent them. But before we discuss all those topics, I want to say hello to Bill Schweitzer and Billy Mecca. Hey, guys.
Jamie Parker.
Hey, doing? Jamie.
Doing good.
Hey, listen, I'm sorry about last time.
I'm not sure I remember about last time.
You don't remember that game of horse?
Oh, yeah, the game of horse. Well, I think it was more luck than skill.
Anytime you're up for a rematch, Mecca, I'm game.
Well, speaking of time, how about right now? The basketball arena is right over here.
Let's go.
Oh, this ought to be good. You know, we ought to head on over to the hockey arena. And today we're going to talk about the challenges that coaches face in recruiting the best players in college hockey. The coaches go out and they're under pressure to find not only the best player, but the best fit for their team. And sometimes they've got to travel thousands of miles to do that.
There definitely are some remote places that we've had to send our send my assistants to. But that's all part of the game, and you know, there's a lot of great hockey players in some remote parts of Canada that we got to get to.
I got to be honest with you, I have slept in my car before, not by design.
My favorite story with Benny is he drove 10 hours to Ontario to watch a kid play.
The player I was going to see that night was actually playing for a good friend of mine. I talked to the player and also to my friend, and it assured me that this player would be still available that night. He was not going to commit to a school.
So Ben drives all the way up there, gets there, the coach says, oh, he just committed to school X. And Benny was not happy.
So got in the car, went to Indianapolis that night, which was another 8-hour haul. And from Indianapolis, we made it to Sioux Falls, where Zach Hansen was playing.
And we ended up getting Zach Hansen, who's a great player for us. But and then he had to drive all the way back because he's got the rental car. So it's a little crazy, and that doesn't happen all the time. But, you know, that is something that happens once in a while, and it's a credit to Ben and his work ethic.
I caught the Mississippi, Chicago, drove by the University of Notre Dame, and ended up in the Poconos before I had a crash that night. So I got a good part of the U.S. on the way home.
The travel for the coaches is extensive, but it's even more of a challenge finding that perfect fit.
It's an immense amount of work to recruit one player, you know, trying to sift through first the talent aspect of it. You know, can they play? Do they fit our style? Then certainly you need to go into the character aspect and do some background on that.
And there's certain guys that won't fit into, you know, to our culture, maybe because they have, you know, a lack of work ethic, you know, and their particular coach won't sign off on them. So we do move on to the next guy.
At the end of the day, we want the best players we can find that have interest in our school and our program and what we're looking to do here, both from an academic standpoint and an athletic standpoint.
But I think the more great character kids you have, the more great character kids you attract.
I always use the phrase, you know, do the right thing when no one's watching. Like Jean-Marc Baudouin's a great example of that. He doesn't need someone there to pat him on the back, hey, you did a great job today, you know, at the school reading to the first graders or you know, helping somebody cross the street. Like, he'll do it whether anybody's watching or not, and that's really, you know, you gotta dig to find that out. But, you know, it takes a little bit of work, but I think if we're focused on that going into it, you can come up with the right guys.
And having a great hockey program with an exceptional academic reputation certainly helps attract the best student athlete.
We have great selling points here to get the top kids. I mean, the rink is, you know, it's one of the best in college hockey. The campus is phenomenal. The academics are great. We win. We score a lot of goals. Kids want to go where you score goals. They don't want to go and play the trap. So we've got a lot of great attributes to attract the top kids.
But also the seeds were planted, I think, 20 years ago when the president took over and started really improving the academics here. Now we have no problem going into anyone's living room and selling our academics.
Just I heard how Quinnipiac every year in and year out, they're growing as an academic school. And I mean, they had like the health science program here is great, and that was one of my, you know, ideas of coming here.
I ended up loving it here. The classroom sizes were perfect for what I wanted, and just ended up working out really well for me.
I think hockey's always a dream to play pro hockey for hockey players, but it doesn't always work out. You never know what's going to happen with injuries and stuff like that. So for me, something to fall back on is really important, and that's why I picked Quinnipiac for that reason.
Quinnipiac's a great university, and we got to make sure that they're going to be able to come and handle the academics, and they're going to make the NCAA clearinghouse. So there's a lot of work that goes into finding the right piece of the puzzle.
The travel is quite extensive for all hockey coaches. A lot of long hours driving alone on snow-packed roads just to find that perfect player.